Hello everyone. In last video, we derived diffusivity equation, which is the governing equation for pressure for a flow through porous media where the flowing fluid is slightly compressible. Now we want to apply this pressure diffusivity equation for reservoir because this diffusivity equation is applicable for any kind of porous media, and we should now learn how do we apply it for reservoir. So before we go on to applying this equation for reservoir, we first want to understand what actually happens in a reservoir when we first find an oil reservoir. So this is an oil reservoir which we have found, let's say today. So today what we would do is we will put a producing well here in the reservoir. And initially, the pressure in the reservoir is Pi. So initially, pressure everywhere is at equilibrium and it is Pi. As we start producing with the flow rate Q, so here we are starting to produce with the flow rate of Q, then because of the compressibility of the fluid inside, the oil will start expanding because of this compressibility. And the volume that the oil is expanding will be produced as we have seen in our material balance. Now, because we are producing, the pressure in the reservoir will start decreasing. So how it would decrease? Near the well, the pressure decreases more, and away from the well, the decrease in pressure is not that much. So in the initial stages, when we can say that we are in transient state, we can assume that at the well, pressure that we will measure is given by PWF or is denoted by PWF. And away from the well, when we have only single well in the reservoir, pressure is PI. And then as time progresses, pressure near the well decreases more, but as we approach away from the reservoir, pressure is still PI till we reach a kind of boundary in the reservoir, as it is shown by this boundary. Once we reach the boundary, we cannot say that now the pressure away from the well will remain PI. It will also start decreasing because here your pressure wave has reached and it will start decreasing the pressure. Now at this point of time, when we have reached a boundary or our pressure wave has reached a boundary, then what would happen is that the pressure in the reservoir will start decreasing with time. So that means now with time, everywhere the pressure would start decreasing in the reservoir. So this comes under semi-steady state, and we will discuss about this also. Then in the third stage, we cannot decrease the pressure in the reservoir any further. We have reached a pressure at the well. We cannot decrease that well pressure any further. So that is why we will not be able to decrease pressure in the reservoir also any further. Now for this, what we do, we will see in the next slide. After we have reduced the pressure in the reservoir such that we are not able to produce anything now from the reservoir, then to increase the pressure in the reservoir or to displace the fluid inside the reservoir so that we can produce more oil, we drill another well, which is called injection well. In this injection well, we inject fluids which are readily available, such as water, gas. Now at one point, a situation would arise that the moles or the amount of the material that we are injecting is same as the amount of material that we are producing, such that the pressure in the reservoir is not changing. So in that case, we will say that we have reached steady state condition for the reservoir. Ideally, we are not at steady state any time in the reservoir because the fluid fluids keep changing. For example, we are injecting water and producing oil, so the saturation of water is increasing while saturation of oil is decreasing. So for saturations we are never at steady state. However, for the consideration of pressure, we can be at steady state when the material, total material inside the reservoir is not changing. Now, we can say that in a reservoir, when we are using pressure diffusivity equation, we will encounter three stages. First one is the transient state, in which the initially the pressure is the initial pressure, and then near the well the pressure is decreasing, and away from the well pressure is still initial pressure, and boundaries have not been reached by the pressure wave. Then we reach a semi-steady state condition where the boundaries have been seen by the pressure wave, and then pressure in the whole reservoir is decreasing. Once the pressure has decreased to such an extent that we need to inject some fluid to maintain pressure or displace fluid, then for the pressure we can say with R the pressure will not change with time. So at every R pressure is fixed and fluid is moving. So here I have shown a typical pressure profile that we will get in a flow when we have a producer and an injector.